Hello friends, I'm going to talk about the brand Disney. So who doesn't know Disney? Most of our childhood memories are actually filled with Disney. And we all have grown up along with the Disney characters. Even if I haven't mentioned the name Disney on the very first slide, still it's very easy to predict its name by just looking at the characters that are present on the slide. There should be a person behind all these creations, right? All the characters cannot come right from the heaven. Actually, these are the characters that brought us heaven. So who do you think is responsible for making our childhood so memorable? Who do you think has helped us improve our imagination levels right from our childhood? Who do you think all these characters are thankful to be present in everyone's hearts? Well, the answer is Walt Disney and Roy Disney. Brothers co-founded the company in 1923. Disney is one of the most famous names in the animation industry, known for providing entertainment directed not only to children but also to adults, with their international theme parks and a world-class animation studio. Now, getting to know a little history of the company, Walt Disney Company has a prestigious history in the entertainment industry. Pitfalls in distribution rights nearly sank Walt and his company, but the creation of Mickey Mouse saved the sinking ship. In 1937, marked the production of Disney's first full-length feature film, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. What does the company actually sell? It sells the experiences through theme parks and resorts. Goods like toys, stationery, home and apparel to books and fine arts. It makes animation and live action movies. So this raises the question that how many business segments the company is actually into? Well, the answer is 5. Till now we have seen what Disney sells. Now let's see to whom does it sell. When we pay close attention to Disney's advertisements, they are not always aimed at children. They are in fact aimed at parents with phrases, "Let the memories begin." For kids, it has animation films, toys and other goods. For teens, it has Radio Disney, live-action films like Pirates of the Caribbean. Disney theme parks were well built for the whole family to enjoy. As we have seen that, what it sells and to whom does it sell? Now the question is how it sells. What does it do that makes customers come back? What does it do that makes loyal customers? To answer these questions, let's discuss the following 4 strategies. Now, these are the 4 strategies that the Disney follows to create and maintain loyal customers. If you take away the theming, there's nothing particularly special about Disneyland's rides. Several nearby parks might have far more extreme and exciting rides. So it's the theme that makes it so special. The very reason customers come back is emotional completeness. They make sure that there is always more to see in Disneyland. Though the number of people visiting the park every day is uncountable, the staff still treats them special. They never let the consumers see the changes they make in Disneyland. Cleaners are invisible. Trees that need to cut down will be replaced in the night. The way Disney attracts customers and the way it perfects everything in treating customers is quite impressive. But how do consumers perceive it? Let's see. The 5 steps in this process include need recognition, information search, evaluation of alternatives, purchase decision, and post-purchase behavior. In all the aspects that Disney has, like movies, theme parks, consumer products, media channels, everywhere the consumer has to go through the process of decision making. Now let's take a movie as an example. First, the customer actually hears of the movie through advertising or positive reviews. Then he thinks of memories that consumer has with the brand. Then he compares the movie with its competitors. And he goes to the movie and watches it. And most of the times he goes to movie are unplanned because the moment he gets to know, the only chance of him getting to know about the company is actually unplanned because of the preview that is released by the company. Now post-purchase behavior. After watching the movie, whether he likes it or not, he spreads. So post-purchase behavior is really important for a product. Now let's take some questions. What does Disney do best to connect with its core consumers? Employees are highly trained by the animators to be friendly with the customers and to win their hearts. Parks and resorts are maintained so well that it's difficult to find even a bit of garbage anywhere. The marketing strategy of Disney is family oriented and build family memories. What are the risks and benefits of expanding the Disney brand in new ways, such as video games and superheroes? Benefits. Makes the acceptance very easy as the brand is well known, increasing the market coverage and bringing the new customers into brand franchise. Risks. As the brand is well known, expectations will be huge for the new product. and the product doesn't satisfy the consumer needs, the brand name gets spoiled. And the competitors the company faces will also increase. So to summarize, we have gone through the history of Disney and how what it sells and how it sells and to whom it sells, and the five business segments of the company and how does the consumer perceive the products. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to present it, and hope you have liked it. Thank you.